Well, I think this whole cycle, it's been different. This Tokyo cycle, it's been different just because it's going to be 1 year later than expected. In terms of preparation, I think I arrived in a better situation than I was 4 or 5 years ago, where of course I lacked a bit of more experience and training probably. So I'm looking forward to this new opportunity. I hope I can put myself in a good position and be able to this time fight for the medals. Well, I think every games are different, and in Rio we knew it was going to be a very hard bike course with the hill being done 8 times, and this time it seems that it's going to be the humidity and the heat, one of the main factors. But I think at the end of the day, you just got to prepare and be healthy and be strong. I think the later you can get into the red zone, the better you are and the more probability of success you have. I mean, I think you can always expect strong swimmers trying to put some gap into the main group, and I think that's what we're going to be. We have to be prepared for that, and to be a very hard bike. I'm sure there's not going to be stops anywhere in any of the groups, and of course my aim is try to have the best swim I can and try to get as close to the front or to the front as soon as possible in order to not spend too much energy and save as much for the run, which at the end of the day is where you're gonna have to be fighting your medals against your competitors. I mean, in Spain, I think individually any of the three men racing will have options to fight for the medals or to be on the top eight, which has the good things and the bad things. Of course, bad things is that it's hard to make team efforts, because at the end of the day, if you're helping one person, you might be going against the other one. So that's what we've done in the past, and it's going to be most likely happening the same, where of course if we during the race are in a situation where we can help each other, we're going to try to do that, because it's our teammates and we want the best for them as well. So but beforehand we all plan to do our race. It's an individual event, and we share the colors, but we all share the same goal, and it's to be on the podium individually. Yeah, the Spanish team for the relay is not decided yet, and it will be done probably after the individual race. To be fair, we haven't been able to race much together in the team, because individually as well we have been focused on world championships individual events, and it has made it much more difficult to combine both. But I think we're going to try to put ourselves in good contention, and it is a very special event. We are all excited about the team relay, so we can just hope to do a good race as well. At this point, I'm trying not to think too much ahead. Past the Olympics, my main goal is to be as good as I can in Tokyo, and I'm going to do my best to be there at my 100%. And after that, I guess you have to check how you feel and what's your motivations. I'm physically feeling okay, and I think as long as I can be competitive, I want to continue racing at my best. But there's an important part as well, and it's the motivation and what you are aiming for, and I don't try to put myself any pressure in terms of what I have to do. I'm just trying to enjoy and make the most of this year, and then see what the future brings us. Well, to be honest, in Spain we had a pretty tough conditions and pandemic situation for everyone, and for us athletes we were able to train for over 2 months, which it's definitely been different for every country, and I think that's why we can't think about what others did, and we can try to maybe be at the same point right now or soon after, because we all went through a different process, and for us it was definitely a long time without being able to do our work, and I've just trying to make my way towards the Olympics, which is my main goal for the year. and I try not to think too much about that time where of course we were not able to do what we like, but we got to take the positives, and we are here today, and we just can look at the future now. We will do our preparation for Tokyo as we do for any other big race, which is do a bit of altitude as it normally works well for us, and after that, and considering the possible humid and warm conditions, we try to have as well a couple of weeks where we can train with that also being a factor. So that's the idea. There's not so much time, we just gotta make the most of it.